Howdy, howdy, howdy. I wanted to answer a question. I got an email, but then I also saw a post here in the group where someone had said that they were averaging $180 or $150, somewhere in there. And you could tell, obviously, they weren't satisfied with that. And I get it. I get it completely. 150 to 200 a day, you know, when you're 3 to 4 hour days, isn't bad money, but it's most of us want more, and there's nothing wrong with that. Now, there's some people are tickle pink with that, and I'm okay with that too. But if you're wanting more, there's always a solution, okay? And it's not robbing a bank or doing anything crazy. So, what I would do if the first thing I would do, and it's because of experience, is most of the people that have sent me information, they have sent me, you know, this question. I've asked them to send me pictures from a distance, pictures up close of their cart, okay? Then I always like to get an address so I can Google map it and Google Earth it and kind of get a lay of the land. And then I'll even do the street view and kind of drive down, not to look for them, obviously. They wouldn't be in the picture unless they've been there for years. But my point is it gives me an idea what I'm looking at. And when I go through these, I turn them into cart critiques. And 9 times out of 10, or 99 times out of 100, so less than 1%, it's something else, but it's usually the setup. It's the setup or something about the setup, something about the vendor, something about the menu, something about the pricing, something about the signage, something about where they are in the parking lot. It's usually something like that. And so, I said the volume's really low. I am sorry. Okay, is that better? Let me try something different here. I have a volume slider. Maybe I can get more volume. How about now? Can you hear me now? Better, 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 better. So, anyway, here's what happens. And you may get background noise because I'm right down at the river. It was a beautiful day, and I could sit at the picnic table at the river. So typically, it's the location. So if the setup of the location. So if you want me to critique that, I will, but I need what I said earlier. I need the pictures up front, up close, back off at a distance, different angles, few pictures, and the address, because I want to see how you're set up. I want to see it up close and personal and then from a distance. I want to see what the customer's seeing. I want to know where you are in the parking lot, you know, kind of give me an idea, draw it on a map maybe, or take a screenshot from Google Earth and mark where you are there. And that helps me get an idea where you are. Thanks for that. I'm glad that it's working. So if you'll do that, I'll help you. And 99% of the times, that's something to do with that. It's something to do with the setup. Now, alternatively, there are some pro guys and girls here in this group that they could do the same. So if you want to post it here in the group and see what the results are, they'll critique it for you. Don't get butt hurt. Look at it and go, yeah, I could change that. Yeah, you've got a point there. Well, these little things, sometimes it's as, some of y'all remember, but I moved a lady. She called me and she needed help, and I got all the pictures, and I had her move 3 parking spaces over. Changed everything. I know that sounds ridiculous, but it changed every freaking thing. So that is one of the things you could do to help is post it in the group. Now let's go to some of the other stuff. The location plays a role, okay? And an important role. So let me give you an example. It doesn't matter if you have 15, you're averaging 20 sales a day, let's say, off of customers coming by of about 100 potential people, about 100, you're getting 20, okay? Or maybe you're getting 18, and you're averaging $10 a meal, so you're at 180 bucks a day. Well, if you've been there a couple weeks, that location ain't gonna get better on its own. Not on its own, that's the key word. It's not gonna become a better location. Like tomorrow, I bet it's better tomorrow. No, unless they're doing some whiz-bang sale and they've marketed it and they're getting more traffic, you're not gonna probably get any more traffic. But there's some tricks to that. But it takes time to build on that. So you literally have to spend a lot of your time in marketing here in the beginning if you want to build a location. Now, I am not a build a location type person. Once I have a good location, I don't mind building it to be better than I even want or better than I need. But I don't want to take a mediocre location and convert it. But some people are okay with that, and there's not a right or wrong there. So I'm going to give you both avenues, okay? Me, if I'm fishing in a pond and all the fish are on the other side, I'm going to go to the other side of the pond, okay? I'm going to try different spots in the pond and see where my results are better. I'm not going to take an average pond fishing trip and hang me an electric light that comes on at night that's photocelled and it's got one of those little, not the bug zapper, but it's a bug, like a wire that spins around and it drops bugs into the pond and the fish start coming to that spot. Yeah, it works great, okay? But it took me 2 weeks to train those fish to come over here for dinner. Well, I don't want to do that, especially in a mediocre spot. Now, if I first show up to a fishing spot and it's really, really good, and I just want to tweak it and make it better, now I'm all for tweaking and putting a light and growing them fish. So that's what you do to a mediocre spot if you want to grow that. If you don't want to grow it, then your next step is, what do I do then? This spot is making me a living, or it's making me enough, I'm just not happy with it. Well, let me give you a warning. If you're not happy with it, you ain't going to be happy long, and you'll probably quit the business. And you'll have missed out on some amazing lifestyle and opportunities had you stayed. So what do you do to change that? You pick those worst crappy days, the ones that average. Let's say it's Tuesday and Wednesday are sucky days. And you start taking those days off, or at least one of those days off, or you leave early on Tuesday and you start looking for better locations. And then once you find one, you take that Tuesday that's an average of suck and you go and spend it somewhere else at a new location. Those are things you can do that would immediately change your income, because you will start making more money because you've put yourself out more. You've bought more lottery tickets, so to speak. Now, you may be going, well, I can't give up $180 that it's averaging me, but it's averaging you that because there's crappy days and better days. So don't do it on the better days, do it on the crappy days. And then find another location. And if you start doing this, you'll be fine. Now the other thing is, and we've talked about this till my eyeballs bleed, right? Is you have to grow your market. You have to grow your business. If no matter where you are, you want more people there. Well, people, if they like you and you're doing a good job, you're gonna attract more and more because they're gonna talk about you. They're gonna be like, did y'all see the post I just did in here in the group? It's one of our group members who posted a picture of his hot dog in front of his napkin dispenser with his logo and stuff, but the picture was sexy. It was something shareable. It was something others would wanna share, something that would make their mouth water if they're hungry, and maybe even if they're not hungry. I can see a donut anytime. I could just eat 40 pounds of ribs and I'm still going to eat a donut. So the challenge is going, okay, I'm going to invest these little bitty extras. I'm not saying spend money. I'm saying invest in yourself, invest in your business. If you have a mediocre spot that you're not satisfied with, I say it's mediocre to you. It's not mediocre to the next guy. He may love $180 a day. Some people may love $100 days. But my point is if you want more, you're not satisfied, To you, it's mediocre. And if you want that spot to grow there without moving, then you need to put in the effort it takes to do that. And how you do that is you do stuff like, now this does cost money, but it pays back royally dividends, great dividends. It's like the Order Grub app, okay? So you go to Order Grub now, ordergrubnow.com. Check it out, okay? If you have questions about it, Keith and Corey know the most about it. But my point is you could pull in new business that may have never come to you, like Corey's story with the car lot. They never would have come to him, but he gets a $90 order from them. Why? Because he made it convenient. So you don't have to do that, though. If you're going, God, Ben, I can't afford $50 extra a month right now. I'm barely making ends meet. I just need this place to grow. I don't want to go to another location. I need this place to grow. Then what you're going to have to do right then, what you're going to have to do is make these little adjustments. And I'm going to help you with that. We can always tweak your setup. Always. So post it up. We'll tweak it. Okay? We'll tell you what our true impression is of it. If you'll give us all the information, I'll be more than happy to critique it and give you an honest to goodness advice and tips that will, not maybe, will make your average income go up. Okay? Now, even if you've already got the perfect setup, there's always things you can do. Always things you can do. Okay? So, now, the next thing that we need to look at is like a... Let me take a sip. You like my hot dog shirt? So, the next thing we need to look at and we need to figure out is what little things can I do to grow my business? And I know we've went over this, but I'm going to do it again real quick. Is make your posts... attractive, cool posts like the one that some of the vendors in here did, okay? Cool videos. Videos do way better, and they can only be 15 seconds long. 15 seconds. You know, Squatch Dogs has a video, literally, slow motion, of him spinning the sauce bottle and putting sauce on a dog. And it's attractive. It's appealing. We're all waiting, and we watch that. That shareable content. Those little ads that I've given you some sample ads to use that are here in this group, use those. Tweak them till you're liking. Make it your own. It can be handwritten. If you're pretty good at doodling, guess what would get somebody's attention today? Post up to your friends or to your local yard sale group a handwritten note with a picture of a hot dog and a cart and go, guess what we're doing tomorrow? Sriracha mayo or whatever it is. I'm just giving you an idea. Handwritten image comes across their Facebook newsfeed. Do you think they're going to read it? Hell yeah, they're going to read it. So I would pay attention to your post. If you look at it, and you really like it, odds are somebody else will. But if it's just the blah, it's your logo, here's where we're going to be. Logo, Ace Hardware today, 10 to 2. Who gives a crap? I don't. Yes, it's great to tell your fans that and still post that on your page, but the shareable stuff, the stuff that matters, is a good image, a good picture, something good. Use your Google. Use your Google My Business, because those go viral. Those actually get top hits on Google searches. They show up in people's news feeds and they don't know how. Okay? So use that. Go to your Google My Business page and post up a short video. 5 seconds, 10 seconds. Dude, you should see this hot dog we're doing today. Comes with a free glass of lemonade after you buy your first one or whatever it is. Have fun with it and you will grow your location. Okay? Let's see. I wrote myself notes because it frustrated me today, because I understand that feeling of not making enough. Like, well, dang, I could have worked at Domino's and made $150 a day and running around in my car. Of course, there's negatives to everything. There's pros and cons to everything, right? But The point is I don't want you to be burned out when you didn't give it the opportunity that it deserves. You didn't give the opportunity your all. And you may be going, well, Ben, I did give it my all. I was there at that location every day and it never got better. I sold 18 average meals a day and at 10 bucks a meal, and it just wasn't enough. I need more than that. And I'd go, yeah, but what did you do about it? Oh, I quit and went to Dollar General. So you're working three times as much for less money? Yeah, but it's every day. My point is that this business, all of a sudden things change if you can see it just for a second, okay? If tomorrow you tweaked a little things, or you went to that new location you had found on Tuesday because Tuesday sucked for you, and you tried it and you made $412.11, would all of a sudden your boost you up? Would you be encouraged, inspired, and go, dang, this is gonna do it. I just need more of them. I need more of those days. And you can have more of those days. It's just putting in, you can't just be settled on a location and then think, oh, it's just gonna get better magically. It doesn't magically get better, okay? Magic doesn't happen. Luck happens. But if you want to make your business successful as you want it to be, you're in control of that. We'll give you the guidance. We'll go, okay, you have a great, great setup. You have a good menu. You have good things. But, man, this is lacking right here. This, you know, I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't have that out there. I wouldn't park your car this way. Little tweaks like that, they make a difference. And you're going, oh, dang, I never thought about that. It's like the guy that I critiqued that had the crap behind his stand. You know, he had a stand, and then behind it was a bunch of crap. And that crap gives the stand a bad appeal, a bad feel. Those things you want to avoid. So if you'll pitch it, if you'll show us, we'll be happy to share our wisdom, is the only way I can put it, because we've all done it. We've been doing it. And if today I was going to set up, I guarantee you, I wouldn't be at a location at 180 a day for long, okay? I'd figure out real quick which days are the best, and those are the days I'm going to work there, and I'm going to be working other locations. Then when I find really good locations, I'm going to build those locations up. That's where I'm going to hang my bug light, and that's where I'm going to run power out to the trees so I can hang that bug light, and I'm going to retrain them fish to eat on this side of the pond. And that's the kind of stuff you got to do. Let's see. Also, picking up gigs. If y'all haven't watched the video I did with Caitlin yesterday, she was nice enough to share of her time. She was hot as hell, and it, I mean, just blistering hot in Ohio. And she stayed after her day to answer questions for me and do an interview. And she shares a lot of stuff there, and you'll have some ideas and you go, oh man, she got lucky. Hell no, she didn't get lucky. She's made every bit of everything that's happened to her because she made it happen. She didn't get lucky. She did the effort. She put Ann Catering. She changed her whole branding to meet the Ann Catering, and she already had a great following with her other brand, but she wanted that catering word in there. So she changed her whole branding, and she went after it, and it's paying off. $1,000 days paying off, okay, like she mentions on the video. And she's not in some big place. She has a 30-minute gig every Friday, that she knows she's going to make $200, $250 for 30 minutes. Takes her longer to set up and tear down than it does to serve, and she's done. You can have that. That's not like, well, she got the last good spot, I guess we can all go home now. No. Once you get the bug, once you catch the bug, and once you see the potential, there will be unlimited spots just open up in before you, but you got to put that out there. We cater. We do this and this. Here's a picture of this cool menu thing I made. Caitlin was pasting pictures on her posts on her personal page and her business page. She was posting pictures of stuff she was trying, creating at home, making this new recipe, making her own sauce. She was posting that up. Well, guess what happened? People shared it and followed it. People start seeing that, and then they want some of that. And then when she set up and she goes, hey, I'm at such and such today. Here's my video. Here's some other vendors. We're having a blast. Come on down. They came down. And that's what happens. So don't be, I'm glad you're not satisfied where you are or with what you're making. I'm glad. Because if you're not and you admit it, it means there's room for improvement, right? There's room to change this. And better to change it now than to wait 3 years and you're looking back. I'm not going to call any names. He's been in here before, about 3 years ago. Okay? He quit the business. Hated it. Got mad at it. Quit. He's back. And he's doing good. He just joined back in the last, I don't know, 2 weeks. And you go, why is he back? Because it works. He got out of it. And then once he's in, back in life and real world stuff, and not that this isn't real world, but you get back into the 8-hour days and then your commute added to it and you start factoring your income, you're like, dang, I should have kept hot dog vending. And what was I thinking? I should have invested that extra time and done some marketing maybe. And free marketing at that. You can post free stuff on Craigslist, Facebook, Google My Business, all those things you can do. Somebody asked, where's the bourbon? I don't have any right here. I don't even know if I have any in the house right now. I've been doing a diet again. I had put on weight, so I had to diet again. And it worked out perfect because I have two adult kids that are stressing me the hell out. So eating wasn't a priority anyway. So it worked out. No bourbon right now. Bourbon's high in calories. So let's see. I like this, whoever posted this. This is stupid. This used to tell me who posts like this. Here, I'm going to put it up on the screen and show you what I see. No picture, no name. Think outside the box. Find something you like and someone else has done and make it your own. Absolutely. So these are things that work. I have a question. We cooked 40 sausages. I only sold 10. Do I need to throw out the other 30? We have them sealed on ice. It depends. If they are safe for refreezing or keeping cold for overnight, then I'd save them. I would say this. Never have 40 sausages already made. People will wait on it, okay? You can have them cold and in literally a few minutes have them hot again. You can have them not frozen to that, but cold. And then it's not the end of the world because you don't want to have a high waste. And once you start getting a feel for a location, you'll know. Like if you heard Caitlin yesterday, she said, I know about how many people are going to eat. Roughly. She ran out yesterday. She could have sold more. But the point is, she knows average. She knows an average. And because she keeps good records, she knows an average, so she doesn't have the waste. Did you see what she's doing with salads? Did you see what she's doing with the little dessert things? Holy cow. It inspired me to see it. I'm looking at these things. I'd be happy to see, this is Berserker Dogs. I'd be happy to see $180 on a daily basis. Okay. And I would have too, because when I started, I made like $92 or $95. It was less than $100 my first day. Okay. And it was pretty much the same the second day. But I was just getting started. I knew nothing. I just knew it was more money than I was making sitting at home. So I was tickle pink. But then stuff starts happening and change starts happening. And you can have all that. You can have every bit of that. You're welcome. I always talk too long and I apologize, but I hope that this helped you. I hope that some of you will go, you know what? I'm going to do that. I'm going to make a commitment that every freaking Monday, I'm going to make up 5 little ads. I'm going to take a best picture I can of a hot dog. I'm going to put it in a black background, maybe hang a black t-shirt up behind it. Okay. And if you don't have anything black, take a Sharpie and take a piece of paper and put it behind it. Take a picture of that, okay? And turn on the flash on your camera. And then now with all these camera apps, you can make it look as pretty as you want. But if you saw the one I just posted up on the group, I can't pull it up right now, that's one of our members here. That's how he took the picture. It's gorgeous. Do that. Do that. Do that kind of stuff. Videos work better, but you can do a short video. Can you imagine the steam rising? Listen to this. This is how my brain works. I got my camera, right? And this, I go up to my cart. The steam's coming out the edges of the steam pan, just coming out. I've just cranked it up for the day, or maybe I've been, it doesn't matter. And I go ahead and make a hot dog that's sexy as heck right on top in the boat, sitting there ready to go with a cold Coke behind it that's kind of wet, right? And I start at the steam and I just go up and it's like a 6-second video. And I go, did it make you hungry? Well, good, we're here for you. We'll be here all day, you know, or whatever it is. We'll be here till 2 or whatever it is. Those little things, people will start sharing them. Did you see that video that Boss Dogs posted? Dang, that chili looked good. And that's how these people are growing. It's not like they won the lottery in hot dog vending. They didn't. So do that stuff. I love you. I wish you well. And I'll see you Monday night. All right. Bye. I got to figure out how to turn this off. There it is.